Now, as we've been hearing in the news this morning, some Suffolk flat owners will not have to pay to replace unsafe cladding under new government plans. The BBC Newsnight's Lewis Goodall has seen the details.
The big, big headline is that around £4 billion of money will be made available to leaseholders in buildings between 11 metres and 18.5 metres to pay for dangerous cladding removal costs. Now, that's big news because up to now, the government's policy has been that only payments will be made for buildings over 18.5 metres. Critics have long said that that's an arbitrary figure and it should be changed.
So what do those affected think? Well, we can speak to Alex Dickin now, who's the founder of the campaign group Ipswich Cladiators. Good morning, Alex. Good morning. Oh, hi, Alex. Sorry. Can you hear me?
I can hear you,
Oh,
yes.
Fantastic, fantastic. So what's your reaction then to this news?
It's a positive step in the right direction, but we have some concerns about the announcement.
Okay.
So first...
I was going to say, what are the concerns?
Yeah. So, unfortunately, the $4 billion only goes towards unsafe cladding.
Right.
And misses out on all of the other potential costs that leaseholders will face for other fire safety defects, such as missing fire breaks, internal compartmentation issues, fire doors, and timber balconies.
Okay. So it's not going far enough?
Exactly. It's not going far enough. And the £4 billion is also on a voluntary basis from developers only. So I'm not sure, and fellow leaseholders aren't sure, how long this $4 billion is going to take to actually raise, and if the developers themselves are going to be willingly contributing to this fund.
Okay. But does it at least show the government's listening?
It does show that the government is listening, but they also need to listen to the detail of the fact that this isn't just a cladding scandal, it's
right.
a building safety crisis where there are multiple issues with our homes.
Okay. This money, though, what difference will it make to leaseholders in Ipswich?
It will mean that they won't face a large bill for their cladding remediation costs, but the potential for life-changing bills and bankruptcy, losing your home, is still there.
Okay.
The cost to fix the other fire safety defects are still going to be in the thousands.
Right. I mean, it's a tough situation, isn't it, for anybody in that situation. How are people in the group coping?
It is extremely tough, as well as the fear of receiving a bill in the thousands or tens of thousands. We are unable to sell our homes or even remortgage. So we are trapped in our properties, unable to move on with our lives. We have no option but to stay put until our buildings are fixed.
Mm. And so despite this news, which is good news, there's a long way to go.
Exactly. It's not the full picture. It's a positive step in the right direction. That the scandal and the crisis has not been ended by this news.
Okay. Thank you very much for taking the time to chat and explain a bit more. That's Alex Dickin there from Ipswich Cladiators.